One of the things you need to do in order to program in Java is install the Java Development Kit, also known as the JDK. And that's actually what we're going to do in this video. We're going to install the JDK version 11 on the Linux platform. Now, if you're running on a Windows machine or a Mac machine, there are separate videos for that. But if you're on a Linux machine, you're in the right place. Let's get started. So at this point now, it's time to download and install the Java Development Kit. And we're going to be using version 11, as we've discussed previously. So we're going to go firstly to the Java website, and that is java.sun.com. And we're going to download the Java Development Kit. So once we arrive at the site, I'm just going to size this up so you can see it. Click on Java SE. SE, by the way, stands for Java Standard Edition. And you can see over here, we've got Java SE 11, LTS. LTS stands for long-term support. And when I come down over here to the right-hand side under Oracle JDK, and I'm going to click on download. That brings us to this page, which is where we can download the JDK. I need to click on accept license agreement. Now, because I'm on Ubuntu Linux, I'm going to download and install the tar.gz file. And that will probably work with most distros. But if you want to, depending on whether you've got Red Hat or Debian or some other distro of Linux, you can download one of these other images. So I'm going to select the .tar.gz. I'm going to save that to my downloads folder. And we'll give that a moment to complete. Now, the process is going to be a little bit different because we're on Linux. We're going to basically move it over manually ourselves into the relevant folder. So to do that, what I'm going to do is go into the command line for this. So I'm going to wait for this download to finish, and then we'll make a start on it. Well, actually, we may as well open the terminal window now while that's still downloading. So I'm going to come up here to activities. I'm going to open terminal. I'm just going to type terminal in here. But you can just open the terminal in the normal way, the way you would normally open it. And again, I'll just size this up once this is finished downloading so we can see what we're doing. I'll just pause now until this is finished downloading. Okay, so you can see that's now downloaded. I'm just going to minimize the browser for now and bring back our terminal window, which I've opened. And I'm going to go into the downloads folder, cd space /, downloads with a capital D. And if we do an ls, we can should be able to see our JDK file there. And what we want to do now is we want to unzip it first. I'm going to use tar for that. So I'm going to make this a bit bigger so you can see the commands I'm typing here. So I'm going to type tar space -xvf space, and I'm going to just type JDK and press tab and choose our version of the GZ file and press enter. And you can see that's unzipped that file there now. And if we have a look again, we can see we've got a JDK 11 folder in the bottom left-hand corner there. So the next thing we want to do is create a directory to store our Java Development Kit. And I'm going to put it in usrlibjvm in a subfolder. And the advantage of doing that is when we come to install IntelliJ in the next video, it looks there by default for that for the JDK, and it'll find it for us automatically. So I'm going to start by typing sudo. We need to do that because we're trying to access files that have been created by root. So sudo space mkdir space -p, and it's /usr/lib/jvm/, and I'm just going to create a new directory and call it jdk-11. Now, if there's a new version of the JDK, there's a subversion that's come out, 11.01, you might want to change the directory name to be that, but I'm just going to stick with jdk-11. And put a /. There. All right, and that's our folder created once I enter my password. Next, I want to then move the contents of our unzipped JDK into that folder. So I'm going to type sudo space mv space and JDK, and I'm just pressing the tab there, /, and then star. So basically the contents of the JDK 11 folder that we've unzipped, we want to move the contents to /usr/lib/jvm/, I'm just going to press tab there because it's the only folder or the only directory in there, JDK 11, and I'm going to press enter, and that's the contents now moved. And just to make sure, we can type ls space slash usr slash lib slash jvm slash jdk 11. And you can see the files within there. We can see a number of folders there. Now, depending on whether you've got Java or the Java compiler configured, we can actually use the sudo update alternatives command to set it up so that Java will work on the command line. So at the moment, if I type Java space dash version, we'll get the fact that it's not found. So if you're happy with that and you're only going to be using Java from the IntelliJ IDE, the tool that we're going to be installing in the next video, you won't need to do this, the command that I'm about to show you. But if you then actually want to run Java from the command line, I suggest you type this command in. So I'm going to type sudo space update space alternatives space minus minus or dash dash, that should be install space, and in double quotes forward slash usr forward slash bin forward slash Java, double quotes, then space, and then double quotes again, the word Java in between, and then we're going to point to Java on our installation. So that's going to be double quotes, forward slash USR, forward slash lib, forward slash JVM, forward slash, and it's JDK 11, forward slash bin, and then forward slash Java. And closing double quotes, space, then 10, 10. And now we can type Java space minus version. And we can see we've now got Java 11 actually working. So I'm going to do the same for the Java compiler. So I'm just going to press the up arrow twice and change Java to Java C here and go back. Change Java to Java C there. And then the final one, the third place, Java C there as well. So we've done the same for Java C, as you can see there. I'm just going to close down terminal window by typing exit. Alright, so thanks for watching. If you've got questions, leave a comment. If you're ready for the next programming specific video, click on the link up here in the top left hand corner of your screen. To look at non-coding programming related questions, click on the link down the bottom left hand corner of your screen. Feel free to subscribe by clicking on the link up here, and I'll see you in another video.